First of all, thank you very much to everybody for joining today. It's very exciting to see all of you. I mean, we met in different editions, so it's nice to have all of you together. Actually, it would be nice to have it like in a real experience. Anyway, this year, unfortunately, we are facing a very hard time, and we have been thinking what to do with the festival, as many other events, of course. And my first idea was to move it to next year, but we were missing something a lot. And we thought that actually reflecting about what has been done during our past 7 years will be very important. And also maybe, you know, projecting some future development of the event will be also be something that needed to be done. So we decided to use the technology and to create a virtual edition. So the edition this year will be mostly a retrospective of what has been done in the past years. So what we are going to present on our Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube accounts will be performances of past alumni that has been awarded with the fellowships for joining the Manes Guitar Seminar and from Manes to join the Lanciano International Guitar Seminar in the past years. And we asked some of the faculties that joined us in the past to contribute with some presentations, and they were so nice to give us some pre-recorded presentations about very important topics like being a musician in the modern era. So we have Michael and Joanne talking about the other art of music. So how many other activities a musician can do besides performing to survive. So they are talking about their entrepreneurship in a musical festival, the Joanne Falletta, with their important school in Buffalo, and with the recording project that they have. And we have Joao Luis that is going to introduce us his current projects and what he's working on right now with his beautiful music. And we also have Laura Altman that is going to share her experience with virtual ensembles, which is something very, very hard that we all faced during this time. So she's going to give us an insight of what she did and how she was able to overcome all the problems with the, you know, delay with the technology. And we also have our past alumna, Hannah Murphy, which is a popular Instagram influencer in the field of classical guitar, which is actually something very important at the moment, we think, because, I mean, it's important to refresh the classical guitar world or the classical music world anyway, and to reach young people. So what she's doing, she's like talking with young people, younger people, and she's sharing with them her experience, and she has been very inspiring, we think. So she is going to give us a presentation on how she does, how she can get to 100,000 and more followers on Instagram. Everybody like a follower of passionate or a guitarist. So it's something very nice. And Frederick Zigante is going to give us a presentation about his last critical edition of Alexander Tasman Homage. And we'll also have a performance by Andrea De Vitis. We'll also have some cultural events. I think tonight we'll host aperitivo with Taverna Anxa, which is maybe some of the faculty of the previous years, or the first years, they didn't go to this restaurant, but Taverna Anxa is a restaurant that was founded maybe 3 or 4 years ago, and the owner is very passionate about what we do, and he hosts and offers a wonderful aperitivo in Lanciano Vecchia, which is the historical part of Lanciano. So he's going to give us a tour in the restaurant, and he's giving us a recipe, so how to make brodetto alla vastese, which is a fish plate from Abruzzo, from Vasto. And then we'll have some salutation from the ex-mayor of Borello that has been hosting us for the past 2 years for this wonderful walk through the Cascate del Verde and hosting our concerts there. And also we'll go to Salle and we'll show some of the videos that we have been looking at in the past years, and we'll have some other videos about the history of instrument strings making from there. So this is pretty much what we are going to have this year.
Isabella, do you know, have we been able to capture the smell from the string factory?
Oh yeah, this is a new technology. <That's kidding.
laughs> from the sheep.
Just thinking about that making me want to try that fish.
Well, come back.
Well, I'll try the recipe. It's not entirely up to us right now, right? Where are you now, Isabella?
I'm in New York State.
In
Catskills, which is a place with the mountain where we escaped since mid-March. And we are trying to go to Italy. It's not easy. We'll try to go. Now that we know that the schools will be online, probably will. I mean, I would love to have some help with the kids. That's my issue.
Well, maybe Elena could just come to your house.
I would love.
Joanne, were you going to ask something?
Yeah, I was going to ask, are you going to have these various things posted somehow?
We can
jump on and view.
We are going to publish the schedule today, and presentations start the 28th with your presentation. And they will be premiered at a certain time of the day. Our premieres will be at noon and then 2 p.m., 4 p.m., No, 10 a.m., noon, 2 p.m., 4 p.m.
Okay. And in Italy, 4 p.m., 6 p.m.,
4, 6, 8, 8 10.
And 10 p.m.
Yes. And but then they will be online.
But we will start tomorrow, Monday, with this welcome.
Yes.
And then in the evening or late afternoon, the Taverna Anxa, our aperitivo.
Okay. Well, questo è un gran piacere vedere tutti, siamo tutti qui insieme, siamo dispiaciuti che dobbiamo andare, abbiamo un conflitto, dobbiamo incontrare qualcuno all'aeroporto. So,
okay.
Ciao, tante
Thank
grazie.
Thank you so much for joining. Thank you and for your presentation, it's amazing.
And thank you for allowing us to be a part of this. I can understand how heartbroken everyone is not being there because of all the fond memories and the people, the food, it's a beautiful area. So wish you all the best of luck and thank you again.
Yeah, we're delighted to be here.
Thank you. Bye.
Ciao, a presto.
Bye.
You know, in the very first...
Bye-bye.
Ciao.
Bye.
Ciao.
Ciao. Ciao, ciao.
You know, in the very first year of the Lanciano International Guitar Seminar, Isabella was not able to be there because she was right. About to have her first child.
Yes.
And she was afraid that if they left the country, they would not be able to come back because visa issues, right?
Yeah. It was not for the baby. It was because I was in a visa switch. And during this time, I couldn't leave the country. I mean, you can't. If you do, you lose everything, and you cannot come. So, and the document was delaying, the new visa was delaying. I actually was waiting for the green card at the time, I think. Or, no, I was going from a kind of visa, J1, to another one, which was H4. And in that period, I couldn't move from the country. This is what happens. They, like, frozen you, and you can't move.
Well, so for Laura and me,
truly treat you like an alien.
Well, it was an amazing experience because we came to Lanciano with a fairly rudimentary Italian skills, and here we are, go run the festival that Isabella had conceived of. And we had a lot of help from two of our first faculty, Gael Solal and Massimo Delle Cese. They were really, really helpful. Omar Crocetti, who we will hear from during the week, the president of Estate Musicale Frentana, was very, very understanding and cooperative with us. And I believe it was that year that Micaela came to give her presentation about the Pita Luga Festival.
Yes, I was there.
And Vito, were you there il primo anno a Lanciano con Camilla e tutta la famiglia?
From first year.
Vito, tu sei arrivato alla prima edizione o dopo?
Alla prima.
No. Ah, ok. Sì. Wow.
Sì, alla prima.
And Micaela, you and your husband, you came with us to Salle also, didn't you? That was the first.
Yes, yes, I remember well. I remember well the visit to the Museum of the Strings. And it was beautiful, and I never met Isabella because at the time I was waiting for his baby, her child. Yes. Right. Yes, but I hope to see you, to meet you in the next future.
I do too, Micaela. I really want to meet you in person. I want to come to Alessandria. I mean, I came once, but so many years ago, so many. I was young. I was like studying probably in the conservatory in my maybe 18, something like that, or 17, something like
that. It's possible, yeah.
And then I couldn't come. I mean, I left, then I started all my travels, so I didn't come anymore, but I really want to come. Let's see. And this year you are doing also an online edition?
Yes, we have no online edition because it's very complicated to have a competition also for us because overall for the travel, because the people coming from everywhere is impossible to have to Alessandria. And for the final with orchestra also, because it's impossible to organize an orchestra together with the winners, etc., etc. So we decided to do one online festival with two in September, not now, and giving the prize to the young people studying. And if you can help me with your students, if you have any students very interesting and could have a cash prize from the Pita Luga competition, special cash prize because this year is online, and we would give this, no cash prize, sorry, una borsa di studio. I don't remember the scholarship. It's a scholarship, yes. We give some scholarship for the people not having any gain during the COVID lockdown. We decided to give this prize during the online edition.
Well, we will certainly tell all of our students about that.
Yes, we have not so many money, but we can share about six prizes, 250 euros about for each one, and we ask them to perform 10 minutes for online for us during the competition time in September.
Great.
Great. Otherwise, we have the competition for composer, but it's not interesting now for you. The composer is online because it's very, very easy to plan the competition, to send the scores. It's another thing. Yeah. I hope to see for this year will be in this way, and I hope to return next year at the normal situation.
Great.
Okay, nice that you are.
Sorry, because my English is not.
Perfecto.
And I'm not. I had no exercise in this last time.
It's great. And Elena, I think I was looking at the calendar and I thought you had come maybe last year, but it's now many years ago already.
Time flies. I don't know what, like three, I would say.
I think it was 2017, no?
It seems right.
So,
the year before John and Michael,
right? Yes.
And you came from Volterra, I recall.
Right, that's right. We drove from Volterra.
Yes, via Cinquecento. Cinquecento X. We filled that car beyond full.
I remember that was a very fun trip, and I remember. Because Italian coffee is so good, and we used every opportunity to stop.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's the most important part.
Yep.
And then our most recent faculty member guest was João just this past year.
Right.
And he premiered his new hair in Lanciano. So we were very, very excited to see him, but I did not even recognize him.
Recognize me.
I said, who's this guy on the street?
You thought it was some like random person pretending to be me. But once I said the word cafezinho in Rio de Janeiro, you both went, oh,
that's him. Right.
In fact, we saw João for the first time in Lanciano at Taverna Ansa. So it'll be fun to watch them create the whole meal for us, even though we cannot eat it. So, João, what are you going to tell about with your new music and your new project in the presentation?
I'm going to basically talk. Well, I wanted to talk about like three different topics that they kind of like they share a lot of things in common, which is like the commission project that I've been like premiering music written for me by Brouwer, Assad, and like some other composers. New Jersey composer Dave Sampson, who actually got a lot of like, he got a lot of guitar scores from you, Michael. Do you remember that?
Was it before yesterday? If so, I probably don't remember.
It was, I think, 2 years ago, well, 2 or 3 years ago. Yes, but anyway, so like the pieces that I've been like commissioning and like premiering during this like COVID, like it's very, I think it's keeping me busy and not like thinking so much about like all like this horrible things that are happening both in the whole world, but especially like it's affecting like my country like really like bad. And then some like collaborations and that I've been like recording recently and also like from the past, like the trio we put together, and I even mentioned that my the composition I wrote for the seminar, for the Menace seminar in 2011, when Laura suggested that, oh, you should write this piece based on like Luis Bonfa's theme.
That's right, yeah.
And then I came, like, it was a Greek, like, it was a Greek gift, right? But I talk about that. We play something, like, you guys with the Brazil guitar duo and my other, like, stuff with Clarissa guitar, like a mandolin player, and also talking about some of my compositions.
Lovely. Yeah. Well, we really, really look forward to that. And that will be coming up in a couple of days. Isabella, where will people be able to see the schedule? Where can we have
we
that
are going
posted
to post the- it everywhere. Like the entire event will be visible on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. So we are going to post the schedule. I'm not sure how to do on YouTube, but we can probably make a little video.
And well, certainly on the website, lancianoguitar.com, can there be a PDF of the schedule there? And then just a link to the Facebook page and the YouTube channel.
Yes, there is already now in the menu the virtual edition 2020 with the presentation, and we can add the schedule. The schedule will be there today, later in the day. And there are already links to the platforms.
Great. We wanted to ask Vito about his experience coming, because when he's been at the Lanciano International Guitar Seminar, it is as a teacher and as a guitarist and a scholar, right? But also as a father of a guitarist, and then also as the teacher of many of the participants who have come. So can you ask him, and he could say in Italian, it's fine. But maybe just ask him to talk about that a little bit.
Vito, no, Michael dice, parlava del fatto che tu hai avuto l'esperienza al festival sia come insegnante di molti partecipanti che sono passati, no, per il festival, sia come padre, che come scholar, come chitarrista, quindi voleva chiederti di condividere la tua esperienza dai diversi punti di vista.
Sì, vabbè, io mi ero scritto qualcosa, no, da eventualmente dire, no, un po' giusto, non so, posso dirlo?
Certo.
Sì, lo dico cerco di leggerlo in inglese.
Ok.
Allora, I think that when an initiative is positive, it means that the people who implement it are special. Even a good idea can be dismissed because most of the time there is no competence, professionalism, and good character. What immediately struck me during the first seminar was the local lack of competition between the students. On the contrary, the collaboration between them was total. Surely, ensemble music has always had the power to rapidly develop the emotional and intellectual understanding of a piece of music and at the same time improve one's forma mentis. Then the individual meeting with the teachers is experienced as an exchange of points of view, and it is not uncommon to see other teachers who follow the lesson of colleagues, once again witnessing the symphonic sense of the seminar. And then visiting a handmade good string factory in Salle was a unique experience. See how from the raw material, with the mastery of Beniamino Toro, a precious harmonic string takes shape. Well, I recommended it to everyone and the guitarists.
Yeah, allora, bravo.
No, così come generale, diciamo, no?
Bravo Vito, bravo, che bravo, inglese.
Bravo. Sì, bravo.
Impressionante, sì.
Great.
Yeah, so one of the purpose of the seminar when I thought about it and we developed it was the cultural exchange. And now we see Michael talking in Italian, speaking in Italian, Vito speaking English. So I think we reached the goal in that perspective.
Sí.
Well, Laura, did you have any things you wanted to add about the experiences that people can be expecting when they watch the retrospective coming up this week?
Well, I hope they get an idea of some of the things they might learn if they came to Italy on another edition in the future, or get a taste of like what it might be like. Of course, you can't be in Italy, and I think that's one of the biggest attractions of the event, is to go to Italy and eat the food and then see all the places. And yeah, that's hard to replace. But you know, you can get a little advertisement from our event this year and get interested in maybe coming and making the journey, which I would say, you know, some people might be concerned that going to Europe would be really expensive, but actually Lanciano is not that expensive as a place to go, because it's not a major tourist attraction like Tuscany for international tourists. So it's much more affordable, and actually a lot more, I would say, maybe realistic. Like, it's like really the way people really live in Italy, and not totally touristic.
Actually, this is exactly what I loved about that place, because like you go anywhere, you go to Rome and it's just like, you're like bumped everywhere. I mean, of course it's beautiful, but that place is so real. It's so authentic. You go outside, like the food market, the fruit market, like everything, the fish market, like everything is just like beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And I think it's fantastic that you guys decided not to skip the year, because whatever it is, it has this continuity. And, you know, I think now everybody would just need to stay afloat to pass this strange time that is happening.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think it's great that you guys are doing it.
Thank you, Alina.
In whichever way, I mean, of course, it is what it is. What can we do? But
yeah,
the spirit is there.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, Alina.
Thank you.
For your words. It's actually has been very strange and also very hard to imagine a virtual edition. But
right,
we also
course.
thought like we should like do it, because it's like a tradition, you know. We
right.
have been doing it
well,
every year.
It is first that, and then, you know, okay, we are, you know, in our careers, we are where we are, but I'm just thinking, how is the, like, how to keep interest and keep young people afloat and people who are really interested in that. All of a sudden, everything just like shuts down. So I think it's very important that I actually very happy to see that people are doing this virtual things, because I think there is something that students can do, like students or enthusiasts or guitarists, and they, I think it's important this time not to lose this sense of belonging to the community. And this is what these experiences present, and just keep us alive, basically. Because I'm sure this will pass. It's just, what do we do in meantime? and in meantime, for everything not to basically completely disintegrate. And I think that's very important to keep the tradition. So I think it's great that you guys are doing it.
Yeah. Well, you
and
know,
I'm happy you got, you sent the invitation last night. I was like, yeah, I'm happy to see all the faces. Yeah. So it's really great. And in a way, in a very, very strange way, this time, I think it disconnects us, but at the same time, it connects us online.
Yes.
So it's maybe we wouldn't have an opportunity to see each other like this, but the opportunity presented itself.
Well, you know, you bring up a really interesting point, Elena. And in fact, 2 weeks ago, when we had the New York guitar seminar at Manus, this was an opportunity for people to get together from all over the world who would not have been able to come to New York. Right. Many of the people who took part in the master classes, João gave beautiful master classes there, many others, these were people who had always wanted these opportunities but could not come to New York.
That's actually
at any time, and now they finally could.
Right.
So
right.
So that's what we're hoping this week, is that people will get this taste of Lanciano, of Abruzzo, of Borello, Salle, and be able to see.
And really would want to come again when things will be able, when they will
absolutely,
be able.
Absolutely. And you know, you were talking about the family connections. João came last year. João, who was in your family, the representation?
So the whole family basically from Brazil, my parents, my aunt, my brother, my...
So they came to Italy?
Yeah, they all came.
So you saw them in Italy, not in Brazil, not anywhere.
No, we go to Brazil. We were in Brazil first, and then we came to the U.S. and then went to we went to Barcelona, like my wife and I and our son, and then we met the Brazilians, like 8 people in Lanciano. That was amazing. It was like the first time my parents. It was their first visit to Italy. And we, like, the way we actually, because we're from São Paulo, we speak, like, the Italian Portuguese, right? As opposed to people from Rio, or, like the Portuguese is really from the people from Portugal. But it was really, like, amazing. There's so much in our culture in Brazil, like, from São Paulo that it comes from Italy. And they loved. And as you said something, Elena, about like Lanciano being, it's so different than other like more.
Yeah, I love
like,
it.
Like Rome or.
Yeah.
And they really felt the kind of like this really, so you can like go to the market, you can really experience like this in a different way because you're
tradition.
Not.
You feel something about tradition that survived through all this time. I mean, Italy is all about Italy, but I don't know. I just love when I travel. I like small places. I enjoy it so much more than big cities. I mean, big cities, of course, but you kind of know what to expect from big cities. But it is the small places that absolutely adorable because you just see this family that I don't know, they bake pizza or they have this restaurant or they have this hotel and the interactions about around the people, it's just fun. I mean, good and ugly, but it's all fun.
Being in a like place that is less fun, like get to see more and understand like how people do things.
Correct. Yeah. Exactly.
And it's interesting you mentioned my family, Michael, because they were kind of like planning on like going to Lanciano this year again. They were so like
upset. They loved it. They loved it.
They wanted to make it like a year, like a regular like thing for their summer, you know? Yeah, that was
Oh,
very
wow. Exciting. Oh, yeah. That's too bad.
It's too bad.
When it all blows over, they can come back.
Yes, that's true.
We have actually also the dates for next year, right?
Oh, great. Great. Good to know.
I should check them, but I will let you know.
Good. Well, Micaela, when you came with your husband, had you been to Abruzzo before or to Lanciano?
To Lanciano was the first time. Mm-hmm. The first time in Abruzzo, and I have very good memories. But I would... I won't interrupt you in this moment because I must go with my husband just to the sea, but
yes.
I would like to share with you, look, just a minute.
Yeah.
Just a minute. I see the video.
There you go. We got you.
This is with you.
Oh. Oh, see, that's what I would like.
Is it a Marocchino? Is it Marocchino?
No, it's a coffee because in Italy now is after lunch. It's the after lunch
time. That's right.
Okay. I wish you a very, very interesting afternoon. And I hope to see you very, very, very soon in another chatting, in another room, speaking about the guitar.
Absolutely. Okay.
All right.
And we will see you at the competition also, I hope.
Nice yes, I wait for your presence. Okay.
Ciao. Ciao,
ciao
Michaela.
Ciao.
Thank you for joining the evening.
Ciao, ciao a tutti.
Ciao.
And one other family mention I wanted to discuss was with Vito, because not only is his daughter Camila a great guitarist, but he has an entirely musical family. Yeah. Vito, can you tell just a little bit about that and how their connection came to be and how in Lanciano, both your kids were able to make music together? And we won't put you on the spot. Isabella, maybe you can do a quick translation for Vito on that.
No, Vito, Michael ti chiedeva di parlare della tua famiglia, perché in realtà anche tu hai una connessione familiare con Lanciano, nel senso che non sei mai venuto a Lanciano da solo, naturalmente, ma con le tue figlie e con tua moglie. E anche parlaci delle attività musicali delle tue figlie.
Vabbè, poi casomai traduci un po' tu, perché... Vabbè,
certo, no, in italiano va bene, non ti preoccupare.
Allora, intanto Lanciano, che da sempre è una cittadina musicale, ha dato l'opportunità alla mia figlia grande, alla mia violoncellista Claudia, di frequentare per 10 anni l'orchestra giovanile di Lanciano. E quindi ha avuto modo di formarsi a livello musicalmente anche per quanto riguarda l'orchestra. Poi è capitato che dopo... E aver fatto questi 10 anni, no, a un certo punto c'è stata la pubblicità del corso di chitarra, così, e quindi chiaramente all'inizio, per curiosità, così ci siamo venuti e ci siamo trovati benissimo per quel motivo che dicevo prima, no? Perché abbiamo trovato questo ambiente, no? E quindi sì, loro suonano insieme, cioè ci teniamo molto. Il fatto di suonare insieme, secondo me, è una cosa fondamentale per un musicista, no? E quindi cioè, è stata una bella esperienza per questo. Allora continuano a farlo. Certo, Camila con l'università, Claudia con l'orchestra dove lavora adesso, no? Sta diventando un po' più complicato. Mentre stiamo cominciando a costruire qualcosa di importante con Camila per due chitarre, no?
E quindi aspetta, fammi tradurre fin qua e poi dico. Vito actually said that Lanciano is a musical city, which is true. Fedele Fenaroli was born in Lanciano and he gave his name to all the cultural association there. He's a musician and composer from the Napolitan school. One of her daughters, Claudia, is a cellist and she plays with the orchestra in Bari of the Teatro Petruzzelli, is a very important theater in Italy. And she has been attending the Estate Musicale Frentana orchestra courses for 10 years. So she was able to develop her skills with, playing in an orchestra. And today she's a professional cellist in an orchestra in Lanciano. And they loved the experience. And when he saw for the first time the advertisement of the guitar seminar, of course he brought his other daughter, which is Camilla. And Camilla is a guitarist and Vito is a guitarist. So Vito is one of the very few father and the guitar teacher of a daughter. because this is very rare, I think. It's not easy, I can tell. and this is very amazing. So, and Camilla has been coming for maybe 4 or 5 years in a row since the very first edition. And and actually I remember when I asked them, do you guys play together? And they said, oh, actually no, because we live in two different cities, because Camilla lived in the north for the university, for college in Bologna, and Claudia was in Bari in the south. And I said, I mean, you are sisters, you have to play together. And for the first time, they started playing together and they started developing this activity. At the moment, they still live in north and south, so it's not so easy, but Vito was now sharing that he is playing with Camilla. And they are developing a project together, and he's going to tell us more.
Nice. Well, and I was just going to say, if you look on the internet now, there are videos of Claudia and Camilla playing together. Beautiful videos, many, many performances.
Yeah, yeah, diceva yeah. Che ci sono tanti video di Camilla e Claudia che suonano insieme.
Sì, no, pensa che hanno fatto i concerti che hanno fatto perché delle associazioni le hanno viste, no? E le hanno chiamate, quindi sono andate a suonare poi in Toscana, e nelle Marche, in Sicilia più
Festival
volte, no? Il Festival di Carpi, hanno fatto un concerto al Castello di Carpi, cioè lì c'è, infatti poi ne dobbiamo vedere un po', perché c'è un chitarrista molto bravo, Antonio Molfetta si chiama, che è stato mio allievo, no? Che... So, c'è un bel seguito, è un buon organizzatore, mm-hmm. Infatti poi vediamo un po', nice. È una persona che possiamo coinvolgere eventualmente.
Yeah, Vito said they have been playing together, actually somebody found their video, one of their video, and invited them, and then other associazioni, other events invited them to play, so they have been playing all over Italy, in Sicily, in Puglia, in the north, in many events. So this video that you can see are from these different opportunities.
See, that's, I'm glad to hear that. That's
yeah,
really good.
Yeah.
Wow.
And Vito, quindi adesso suoni con Camilla, hai detto?
Sì. Stiamo preparando un programma bello.
Bello.
Sì,
e
sì,
quando lo inaugurate?
Ma io, guarda, lei ormai gli è rimasta la tesi, sta ormai agli sgoccioli, mm-hmm. E abbiamo cominciato, no, a costruirlo. Secondo me entro la fine dell'anno e sarà pronto.
So they are working on a program that, because Camilla is graduating in this period, so she's busy, they plan to be ready by the end of the year. So they are going to premiere a new program together.
Nice.
That's
nice.
Great.
Hey, everybody, I have some news, and if you can see the trees behind me blowing, there is a storm that's coming our way, and we have been talking for almost 50 minutes, and we
almost,
promised...
Yeah, close to an hour.
Yeah, we promised everyone it would be a quick hello.
Yeah.
So if anybody has any final words to add, we would... love for that, and then we can sign off.
Oh, I have to like really like leave. I just want to say thank you, and it's so great to see you all again. And yeah, it's so important to like keep going, and I think I'm really excited about this virtual seminar, really.
Okay.
When you're with good people, you know what, it doesn't matter. You know, you guys are like the best, and then it's gonna be great. That's what I love about. I don't care if it's like online, if it's in, of course, in person, you always have that component, cafezinho, hugs, Brazilians love to hug, and the Italians love to kiss, but still, like, it's so great to see you all, and it's gonna be great. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you,
Joao. Thank you,
Joao. Obrigado, Joao.
Bye,
thank
you.
I'm gonna buy too, because we have to get out. We have to leave today, so
okay.
We have to get all packed right. And
everybody
get going.
Stay well. Great to
see you. Yes, stay
bye.
Well.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Goodbye.
Thanks, Elena. Bye. Thanks, Vito, also. And we will
bye.
See you soon, I'm sure.
Ciao.
Ciao. Bye.